mystery man came over and he said, "I'm out of sight." He said, "For a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to take him his regular fee, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me." But I said, "Look here, brother, who you jabbing with that cosmic debris? Now who you jabbing with that cosmic debris? Look here, brother, don't you waste your time on me. The mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foam goo, but it told me right then when the top popped open there was nothing in his box won't do. With the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo, he said, you might not believe this little fella, but it'll cure your asthma too." And I said, "Look here, brother, who you jabbing with that cosmic debris? Now what kind of guru are you anyway? Look here, brother, don't you waste your time on me. Don't waste your time." "I've got troubles of my own," I said, "and you can't help me out. So take your meditations and your preparations and ram them up your snout."
"But I got the crystal ball,"
he said, and held it to the light. So I snapped it all away from him and I showed him how to do it right. I wrapped the newspaper around my head so I looked like I was dead. I said some mumbo jumbles then, told him he was going to sleep. I robbed his rings and his pocket watch and everything else I found. I had that sucker hypnotized, he couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around. I said, "The price of meat has just gone up and your old lady has just gone down. Look here, brother, who you jiving with that cosmic debris? Now is that a real poncho or is that a Sears poncho? Don't you know you could make more money as a butcher? So don't you waste your time on me. Don't waste your time on me."